So it's Sunday morning. I hear Outlaws boxing with Brandon Krause. Break down the fights you saw yesterday. HBO and Showtime. Showtime and HBO.
Yeah, a whole lot of boxing. I spent the majority of time on Showtime. And starting with the Bika and Durrell fight. What a rough and tough fight. Any fight with Sakir Bika is a rough and tough fight. And Durrell, Anthony... The better Durrell. Yeah, the dude is pretty mean. He's got some punches to go with all that boxing skill that it doesn't seem like his other brother has. Not trying to put him down or anything, but he seems like the better brother. Anyway, Sakio Bika bringing it tough also the entire fight. And rude and crude, but does enough to salvage his title via draw. And I don't disagree with it. I think it's a draw. I don't think anyone ran away with it and showed that they were the one to get the decision, especially to get the take a championship from another guy. I was kind of flipping back and forth. I unfortunately didn't see the Tapia and Kirkland war, but I hear it was awesome. I'm going to watch it tonight.
It was a good one for three rounds. And then round four and half of round five, they should have stopped it earlier, but it was good.
And then Showtime after that was bringing us...
Porter Alexander?
Yeah. I guess somewhat of an upset. I'm saying that, look, I have been saying this. If Amir Khan really wanted to fight Floyd, he should have just went and fought Alexander. Look, you probably would have won. And then nobody would have been saying shit because then you would have earned your space at that big payday. I bet you Amir Khan's kicking himself somewhere going, you know what, I could have been that guy. Anyways, he did.
Lara Trout?
Lara Trout, a fun fight. A fight that I expected to be pretty dull. And it kind of started that way, but...
Didn't end that way, though, did it?
Yeah, it sure as hell didn't end that way, because Lara seeming lately to, at some point, figure these guys out and hit them with some pretty big guns, you know, the same way he did to Angulo earlier, and the same shit he did to Trout last night, you know. Things were going fairly even until Lara discovers something... and unleashes some serious firepower, and it's nice to see that he has it. Add a little excitement to him and make the fans eager to see him again. And then...
Then you saw Rigondeaux fight, or do you see Pauly fight? Pauly Judah or Rigondeaux?
When given the choice between what to watch, I chose to watch the All Brooklyn Showdown, and it was fun. Zab didn't really bring it. You know, maybe Zab at this point goes, hey... The guy's not a big puncher. He's not gonna hurt me. If I just go out there and don't look too stupid, I'm gonna make some money. That's kind of how it seemed like to me. I picked Pauly to win, and he won. Actually, all my picks worked out the way that I thought, aside from the draw. Pauly, too fresh, too young, too good a jab, too much movement, probably always gives the style. Like Zab's problems, but especially at this stage in their career. And then, yeah, I was flipping back and forth to Agbeko Rigondeaux, or should I say Rigondeaux Agbeko. And every time I watched it, it seemed like I was watching the same thing, that Rigondeaux was just outclassing Agbeko. Agbeko wasn't going to turn the tables. Agbeko also wasn't going to get knocked out. So I chose to keep watching Showtime.
What did you think? Your conclusion is... boxing filled weekend?
I think it's awesome, and now we have more awesome fights next weekend. It's really great way to end the year. People are talking about boxing in December. People are eager to see these fights. People know the actors, know the players, and boxing is awesome, and that's what's up.
There you have it. Brandon Krause here at his gym Sunday morning. VSNewsReport.com. I'm Ellie Sackback reporting.